Somewhere out in the Nevada desert, a strange vehicle tears across the landscape. It's tracked like a tank, except it sports oversized treads in comparison with its relatively small body, which only holds two occupants. It also moves faster than a tank, hitting speeds of up to 60 miles an hour, while retaining its ability to climb grades as high as 70 degrees. Yet what exactly is this tiny super tank good for? And why is the US Army so interested in it? Hello and welcome to another episode of the Infographics Show. Today we're taking a look at the Ripsaw, the possible US Army's futuristic luxury tank. The Ripsaw has been around since at least 2002, but it started to gain fame in 2010, when the US Army began testing the vehicle for possible adaptation into its inventory. It wasn't until Fast & Furious 8, though, that the rest of the public got a very impressive look at the capabilities of the Ripsaw, making its big-screen Hollywood debut and wowing audiences with its speed, maneuverability, and versatility. Yet, as badass as the Ripsaw seems, and admittedly, it does look pretty badass in pretty much everything it does, the US Army has, after 9 years of testing, still not found a use for the Ripsaw. Original interest in the Ripsaw stemmed from President Obama's order that the US military begin slowly shifting its focus from fighting low-intensity conflicts around the world against insurgent or terrorist forces back to countering the growing power of China and Russia. Over the course of the US's global war on terror, the military has seen its capabilities to fight large-scale, high-intensity conflicts severely atrophy, putting it at risk should war break out between US and China or Russia. Whereas once the US Army was focused on countering hordes of Russian tanks across the plains of Eastern Europe, its focus shifted on developing a smaller, much more mobile and responsive force that could best respond to the threats posed by insurgents and terrorists. Investments in new weapons and technologies were prioritized for tech and gadgets that gave soldiers an edge in the house-to-house urban fighting of America's war against terrorists, or in surveillance technologies and rapid-response kinetic attack capabilities for quickly eliminating high-profile individuals as they appeared. With Russia kicking off a moderately successful rearmament program in the early 2010s, which continues to this day, and China seeking to grow its naval and air force capabilities in a bid to challenge the US for supremacy over the Pacific, President Obama started a slow recalibration of the US military's mission from low-intensity conflict back to its roots as a force meant to fight and defeat two major powers simultaneously anywhere in the world. That meant a reinvestment in frontline combat systems, such as tanks, anti-tank weapons, and new bombers. Yet the slow expansion of Russian ground forces and their increasing adaptation of ground combat drones sees a need for the US to supplement its infantry with a light tank or light tank equivalent. Currently, the US Army finds itself with a pressing need for a light anti-tank weapon system that's fast, agile, and somewhat survivable, which is where interest in the Ripsaw kicked off. With a 750-horsepower diesel engine, the Ripsaw has about half the power of an Abrams, but on a much lighter body. This lets the two-seater Speed Demon reach speeds as high as 60 miles per hour, while giving it the agility and power to scale steep inclines as high as 70 degrees. Its oversized tracks make it the perfect off-road vehicle, and in testing, it's proven that there's very little terrain that can stop the Ripsaw. So why isn't the US Army adopting what seems like an obvious fit? For starters, the small crew capacity makes the Ripsaw a bit of an unappealing option. Yet the vehicle does come with built-in capabilities for being remote controlled, with the heavy investments by Russia into electronic warfare, which greatly outclass America's own efforts. A remote control functionality is not very appealing at the moment. While a new focus in 2010 for the development of more robust electronic warfare capabilities in order to catch up to and exceed Russia and China, this may make the Ripsaw more appealing in the future. But as it stands, the US military is leery of investing heavily into unmanned ground combat vehicles, exactly because of the advantage that Russia currently has in electronic warfare technologies. The reasoning is simple, and it makes a lot of sense. Losing control of a drone flying over a battle space means losing a set of ears and eyes, but losing a frontline combatant means losing a significant force multiplier and putting friendly troops at great risk. Even in a manned configuration, though, the Ripsaw is too lightly armored to really fit the light tank role required by the US Army, who has fast-tracked an acquisitions program meant to procure a valid vehicle for the role. Right now, the Army is being forced to rely on Bradleys and an expensive upgrade program for some of its Striker fleet to fill the role, and a dedicated light tank platform is desperately needed. The job of a light tank is to quickly move in and out of combat and outmaneuver the heavy main battle tanks, while providing fire support in situations where big main battle tanks aren't available or can't operate safely in. Relying on speed and firepower, a light tank should be able to knock out a main battle tank, while providing at least some survivability should it be struck in return. At minimum, a light tank should be resistant to 50 caliber and limited RPG fire, drawing fire for and protecting the infantry it directly supports. Yet the Ripsaw is completely unarmored, providing zero protection for its crew. The vehicle is also simply too light, weighing in at only 9,000 pounds, while an Abrams comes in at 70 tons. This lightweight means that the Ripsaw is not suitable for many of the heavier fire support options that a light tank needs. In fact, the Ripsaw is only rated to house the common remotely operated weapon station, which is capable of mounting the M2 50 caliber machine gun, the Mark 19 automatic grenade machine gun, or an M240 Bravo or M249 SAW. While all of these weapons would make for great fire support against targets such as terrorists and insurgents, none of them pack the punch necessary to go toe-to-toe with a modern armored vehicle. Russia, for example, fields the Sprut SD light tank, which features a 125mm main gun with a 7.62mm coaxial machine gun. Its main gun can also fire anti-tank guided missiles, if available. Armored with aluminum and steel, the Sprut is able to protect from 23mm cannon rounds, small arms fire, and artillery splinters. If the Russian Sprut were to come face-to-face with a Ripsaw, the Ripsaw would be a mess of mangled metal in seconds. Yet the US Army has been trying very hard to find a place for the Ripsaw, and consistently failing. While the Ripsaw can be armed with a Javelin anti-tank missile and could in theory make for a good tank killer, its complete lack of protection once more makes it an incredibly unappealing option for the role. Troops potentially assigned to operate the Ripsaw against a Russian tank would not be blamed for remembering the terrible Shermans from World War II, which were notorious for exploding after a single hit by a German panzer. This earned the Sherman the nickname Ronson after a cigarette lighter amongst the Germans, because just like the lighter, a Sherman would always light up the first time, every time. With such equally bad protection, if not worse, at least a Sherman could withstand small arms fire, assignment to a Ripsaw against modern Russian forces would be tantamount to suicide. Alternatively, the Ripsaw has also been reviewed for possible use as an ambulance, and indeed here its high speed and extreme maneuverability make it a very appealing prospect. Yet again though, its limited crew capacity sinks the hopes of using a Ripsaw as a battlefield ambulance, as the vehicle could fit at best a single casualty with no room for an attending medic. Not to mention that in modern conflict, casualties would be in the dozens, necessitating a vehicle that could accommodate several casualties at once. In the end, the Ripsaw has yet to be formally rejected by the US military, but it has also failed to find a place in its inventory. We here at the Infographics Show suspect that the only reason the US Army is still testing the Ripsaw and trying to figure out how it could fit in the current fleet is because, without a doubt, the vehicle is quite badass. It's fast, agile, and can take you literally anywhere. But with zero battlefield capabilities, we think it's time that the Army grow up and put its toys away, because the time to focus on serious weapon systems for future conflicts is definitely now. What do you think the Ripsaw could be used for in combat? Let us know in the comments. Also, make sure you check out our other video, the US's secret underwater spy technology, the US Navy's SOSUS. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!